Now, one of the most baffling things we come across is, as human beings, and especially us as roofers, is this thing called capillary action. Now, what is capillary action and how does it affect us in the roofing industry as roofers? It can be quite difficult to describe capillary action and how it behaves and why it behaves, but the best thing to do is just to show an example of how capillary action works. So we've got here a cup of water and a toilet roll. So with the help of a bit of water and a toilet roll, we'll now demonstrate what capillary action is all about. Give the toilet paper a bit of structure. And as we introduce the toilet paper into the water, notice how the water starts traveling up the toilet paper. You can see the dark lines indicating moisture traveling up the paper. And in this case, water is actually defying gravity, because you can see that water actually travels uphill. This is capillary action, and you can go all scientific about it and figure out why it actually happens. But it's a phenomenon that just happens, and it's something that we have to live with. So, as roofers, how does this phenomena called capillary action affects the work that we do? We in the roof repair business have come across lots and lots of situations where capillary action has been the cause of water leakage. So what are these instances? Where do they occur? Exactly what happens when it occurs, and what do we do to fix it? So in this series, all around capillary action, we'll look at each individual case where there has been a problem with capillary action, or cases where manufacturers have actually developed their products with facility to prevent capillary action. And if we ignore how these materials have been designed to cope with capillary action, then we can negate everything that they've done and actually make the situation worse. Now, the most common metal roof profile here in Australia is the corrugated profile. And the area where it is susceptible to capillary action problems is the good old lap, where you've got one sheet and then you've got the next sheet that laps onto it. It might look fairly simple, but there is some thought put into how the roll formers have actually rolled all the corrugations, because this last corrugation is in fact rolled a little bit different to all the other corrugations. And let's have a closer look at how this is done and why this is the case. Now, this is the underlap, and this sheet is installed first, and then this then laps over the top of the underlap, and it laps about in that location. So let's have a look at how this is supposed to work. When we have rain fall along here, water gets sucked up. And as the water gets sucked up via capillary action, if there's an air gap right up here, then the water will stop traveling. You've actually stopped the capillary action from happening. So when this it's a sharper curve, and you've got a half, you've got like a little crescent in there, right, like that, then the water can only travel up so far, and then it drops back down again, because this is what they call the anti-capillary action. So this is the first point of resistance for this particular profile, is that this is well sharper than that, and that gives you an air gap. Now, what happens if that air gap is destroyed, like if you were to screw this sheet down and you really put a lot of pressure on it? So if you put a lot of pressure on it, right, you've actually taken away this air gap. So now the water can actually drift up under this roll and come back in again onto the underlap. So the reason for having this underlap is that it's the second resistance to capillary action. If water does get drawn in, you've got an underlap in here that carries the water down into the gutter, and you don't get water go into your roof cavity. Not only that, if we have a look at how this underlap is designed, that underlap is designed with a flare that way. So it deliberately creates a gap right there. So if the water does come in, it won't climb up this surface, because there's an air gap deliberately created, because they've actually flared that edge outward. So if you have a look in detail here, you can see that that edge is actually flatter than what that is. So they've deliberately created another anti-capillary action feature right on here, so that you have an air gap, so the water doesn't climb over that and go over. We all know how the designers have put a lot of effort into actually designing in anti-capillary action in their product, but there's still a lot of instances where us installers, if you don't know why capillary action is a problem, and that there's certain ways that you have to install this product, then we can actually destroy the anti-capillary action of this product. And there's many instances where this can happen.